everyone, Jason here, digital marketing consultant, and in this video, we're gonna talk about the oh-so-fun topic of file management. Yay! I know, it's not at the top of any entrepreneur's or business owner's list, but it's something we all have to deal with. So I wanted to share with you my four-quadrant system for keeping myself and my team organized so we never go, where the heck did that file go, anymore. And so make sure you check out the timestamp table of contents in the description to skip around this video along with some other helpful videos to help you be more productive and organized with your time and team. So let's go ahead, jump in, and then at the end, I'll walk through my Google Drive to show you how this actually looks in real life. So the four digital business quadrants are team, content, sales funnel, and product. And so essentially we try to get anything we're working on or any file we have into one of these four main categories. So in the team category, we have all of our administrative files, the boring tax and legal documents, contracts, and then we also have all the files that pertain to training people on our team. So if we have any processes, for example, like you'll see later, we have processes for posting YouTube videos or hiring new people. We put all of that operation style stuff inside of the team folder. The next folder we have is content, and this is where we put all of the actual content files that we use to create our content across social media and our blog. So when we're writing blog posts or we're putting together YouTube videos, doing stuff on Instagram or Facebook, all of those files stay in this folder. The next folder we have is sales funnel, and this can be organized in two different ways. Number one, it can be organized by traffic source if you only have one product or service offering, or it can be organized by funnel if you have multiple products and services. So as you'll see later in this video, I actually organize it by products and services, but if you're organizing it by traffic source, essentially anything you're doing with Google ads or Pinterest ads or Facebook or Instagram or YouTube ads, you'll have a folder for each one of those traffic sources, and then all of your sales copy and the images and the videos you're using for those campaigns can go inside there, one easy place, and then you're not going to miss anything when you're trying to set up your next campaign. Now the final one we have is product, and this is where you're either going to store your client files if you're a services-based business like we do for our agency, or you're going to store all your digital products like your ebooks and your course files and your coaching student notes. And so this is really just going to depend upon the type of business you have. For example, what I'm going to show you now is how I organize this in my Google Drive. I call this folder product for myself, but then when we're in our agency team drive, we call it clients because that's where all of our client work goes. So let's go ahead, jump into my screen, and I'll walk you through exactly how to apply this in your own Google Drive or whatever file management system you are using. So as you can see here, this is our Google Drive, and we have two extra folders in here. We actually have collection box and we have media asset library. And this is something that I developed later on, and this is where you just kind of have to be a little fluid with what works for you. So collection box is where I put things and people on the team put things when we're not quite sure where they're supposed to go or it's just temporary. So you can see in here, I have some video tests that I'm sharing with my co-founder, and then we have some lead magnets that we're working on with each other back and forth. So that's pretty much all we do with the collection box, and eventually those files need to go in the proper place somewhere. But it's good to just have a place for people on your team when they don't know where to put something. Collection box has you covered. The other one we use is media asset library. And so this is where we store all of the media assets that we have. So if we buy stock footage, if we have photos, our logos, presentation templates, they all go inside of the media folder. And that way it's very easy for anyone who's on the team, even if one person's maybe working on Facebook ads, another person's working on a YouTube video, all of that media stuff can go in here that isn't necessarily specific to one project or one piece of content. So for example, if we click on media collection box, you'll see that there is a bunch of videos that need to be organized for other YouTube videos and some screen captures that need to be organized. So this is where we drop all of our, oh, you can see I made a mistake there. That's embarrassing. You can see that we drop all of our media files in here, and then eventually they're organized into their individual media folders or in their content or sales funnel folder. So I just wanted to share those two quick ones with you. So let's go ahead and dive into the four quadrants. So the first one we have here is team. And And as you can see in here, it's very simple and straightforward. I'm actually a little OCD, so I have templates for each quadrant that we use when we come up with internal business processes. So for example, if I went in here and clicked on management, you'd see all of our files related to hiring new team members, and then we also have our brand style guide. So if we need to hire someone new for our team, we have a process or some generic Upwork templates that we can use to find somebody new, and then we have a brand style guide, which I definitely recommend you create for yourself so everyone knows what our colors and topography is for our company. Now, let's say we're training someone new for creating content for YouTube. So I come in here to the content team, and you'll see that there are actually individual folders for each one of our platforms that we're focused on. And when I click on YouTube, then now you don't have to be this OCD. I'm just showing it as an example. And I click on production. Now all of the videos and training that relate to creating the YouTube video, editing it, and post-production and all that fun stuff is in here. And so we save everything in one place. Here's all the training. So if someone new comes on, or we want to change up how we're doing our process, we know that in the team folder, we have all of our training and process documents. So I'll go back out to our main Google Drive here. And this is a team drive folder, by the way. This isn't my personal one. So there's a lot of other people inside of this. So the next one we have is content. And content we just break out again by the different platforms. So if I were to go into YouTube, actually rewind a little bit, just wanted to point out that we actually started doing archive folders. And so this way we can selectively sync these folders to our computers. And then every week or month, we move all of the old files into archive. That way our hard drives don't get all muddled up with old content. So if I click here on YouTube, let's say I want to see the files for the video we're recording right now. This is video code S34. So I would come in here and I'd go to the S folder, and then I'd click on S34, which is the only one there, and I can see the presentation, and I can also see the notes for the video that's being recorded right now. And so everybody knows that they can come into the YouTube content folder and find all of the files that are for videos that are about to be posted or videos that are still in production. So if I come in here to our marketing series, you can see M80, our Google campaign template, is just about ready to go. We have our Pinterest image, we have our YouTube thumbnail, and of course we have the video that's ready to go. So whoever is going to be posting this knows to come right in here, and all the files they need are right in this folder every single time. So we'll come back out here to Entrepreneur, and we'll go into Sales Funnels. I'll speed up a little bit. So Sales Funnels, you can see, we just make a folder for each one of our funnels. Now for us, I'm a little OCD, so the funnel doesn't always necessarily correspond to the product or service because we have upsells and downsells. So sometimes one funnel is going to have multiple products or multiple combinations of products. So that's why I don't necessarily correspond our funnels to our funnel codes to our products. So for example here, this one's Tube Machine is for a course, and Six Figure Influencer, this is for a specific course. But then we go here, Act Agency Box, that actually combines multiple products and services. So that's why I don't have products and sales funnels in the same thing, because they're not always a one-to-one relationship. And then finally, we have products, and this is just where all of our digital course files are stored. Once it loads, there we go. All of our digital product files are stored. So now that it's loaded, that's pretty much all there is to show you with my file management. So I sincerely hope this gives you some ideas of what you can do to stay organized. So you can copy this for yourself, you can come up with your own folders, but as a general rule of thumb to get started, you just want to think of 3 to 5 folders. If you could only make 3 to 5 folders for your entire organization, for everything that you do, what would you call them? And so that's essentially where I started. That's how I came up with my 4 quadrants. And then later on, I added the collection box and the media asset library. So I wound up having 6. So it's definitely a fluid process. You're going to figure out what works for you. But if you start off with 3 to 5 big ones that you know are going to work, you can throw all of your files in there. And then eventually you can get as OCD as I am, or not, and have have subfolders on subfolders. So thank you so much for watching. I sincerely hope you got some value out of this video and have some great ideas on how you can apply this and become more organized with your file management. Comment below if you have any questions or another way of doing it, because your questions and suggestions are going to help other entrepreneurs and business owners get organized so they can move on to the other things that they actually enjoy. So hit that like button, subscribe, and as always, keep building the business you love.